you know, I don't know if I'd go as far as say spiritual person, but I do believe that there is a sort of plan and that things are written out for us and we kind of choose between one or two paths, but most of it's kind of ready and we just have to be bold enough to do it. You might not have thought you were, but everything you've done since you were six has led to this moment.
Serena has this unbelievable ability to keep us so calm in some of the highest pressure moments that you'll ever be in as a footballer.
She installed a philosophy that we're all straight away on board with.
I think most of all, belief came in this team and a really, really strong internal power of wanting to win every game.
We genuinely believed, I genuinely believed, that we could go all the way. We had these players that could just produce these magical moments out of nowhere.
I just didn't feel like we were destined to go home. I thought we were destined to bring it home.
Deep in my heart, I knew that we had the talent in that team to win it.
In the months leading up to the Euros, England had been unbeaten under Serena Wiegmann. There was a lot of excitement about what she could do and how far this very talented group of women could go.
Very nice too.
I've got my shooting boots on today.
But England weren't favourites. The bookmakers didn't have them as favourites.
We've had a history of near misses.
The last time England were in a final was 2009 Euros. The public probably didn't even know we had a final, really. Hadn't even introduced central contracts then, so there was a lot of girls playing football part-time.
For European glory for the all-conquering Germany team.
We ended up getting beat 6-2, so it was a very bad day kind of at the office for us.
It felt this summer that there was a different vibe around this group of women, and they had a new captain and a young captain.
I think I had, you know, 6 minutes under my belt from the World Cup. I don't know, it was a gamble, I suppose you could say.
There was campaigns left, right and centre going on.
Couldn't even walk down the shop without seeing a lioness on a bus stop, on a crisp packet, on advertising boards. They were absolutely everywhere, and that's never happened before.
It was a case of this could be a turning point for women's football.
I suppose success would have been getting to the final, at least, just because we'd always been a semi-final team in this generation.
I never wanted to again reach another semi-final and not make it.
One of the main things was us growing the women's game. Can we inspire the next generation?
And what I was hoping, what I was quite nervous for them, is that they could justify themselves and show that, yeah, we deserve to be on this stage.
We always knew it was going to be so big because it was in England. There was no other football tournament going on. All eyes are going to be on this tournament and therefore on us.
Finally, today is the day, the first day of those championships. England is the host. Tonight's first England game against Austria happening at Old Trafford is sold out. More than 500,000 tickets for all the matches have already been sold before a ball has even been kicked.
The day for the players to feel that weight of expectation. The stadium was packed. I remember walking out and I normally look for my family during it and I couldn't this time.
Definitely think there was like an edge, maybe a little bit of anxiousness.
In the lineup, our families were direct.
Yeah, we were very emotional, but what a feeling to play in front of that many people for your country at home, Euros.
Hemp wins it back. Kirby to Beth Mead. Is this the moment? Off the line. It's a goal. It's been given. Unbelievable scenes.
And what a sensational finish from Beth Mead.
She's on her revenge tour, left out of the Olympics last year.
It was a cagey affair against a good team.
Barbara Dunce with some direct running at England that opened them up. Win not sealed yet.
Kind of that first game, first tournament nerves a little bit. I think we put it down to big crowd, the expectation. Got the goal, got the...
Not the most convincing win for England under their new head coach, Serena Wiegmann, but a vitally important one. And a memorable night in a record-breaking crowd at a European Championships at Old Trafford. It's Beth Mead.
The prettiest of performances, it was a very nervy performance, but they got a win, and I think what that win did was bring the fans back.
Beth Mead's first half goal gave England a winning start to Euro 2022 as the Lionesses beat Austria 1-0 in front of a record crowd of over 68,000.
Well, a glorious summer's day across the region, blue sky, sunshine and very high temperatures.
A nervous start against Austria, but this is going to be the test of the group.
If England can win tonight, they will be into the quarterfinals. They just need to get past Norway.
People don't realise how good a team Norway are, especially with Hegerberg coming back, their main talisman, coming back and being at the lead of their...
Game two for England. And after the emotion of Old Trafford, it's the Lionesses' toughest opposition in the group stage. Two times European champions Norway. A crucial game between the two favourites to progress to the quarterfinals.
Since Serena took over, we played against teams that we should have been putting away a lot more. The fact is there were some times that we were very
top, and it was a bit of a cagey kind of 15 minutes where we were finding what was working for us, what, you know, who do we need to get on the ball, how do we find the space, what's the right movement.
Penalty!
First goal came and it was just a massive, ridiculous breakthrough for us. We were suddenly like, we can't stop now, we need to keep the momentum.
Literally, it felt like every wave of attack we scored. Every shot was a goal.
It's Mead, away with it!
I don't think they've figured it out yet. It was like, get it to Beth.
So much space for Mead. Oh, that is sensational!
Goal after goal after goal.
Oh, it's six!
That was England unleashing their full arsenal.
Alessia Russo!
Didn't expect to be so quiet, for sure, but more than happy to be.
Everything went right.
They go through to the knockout stages in style as winners.
Scorelines like that in a Euros, it really doesn't happen. The teams are so close in Europe. The standard is phenomenal. So to see that happen, I still can't believe it happened, even though it did.
What was your feeling at half time when you walked down the tunnel and thought, oh, I've got to do a team talk and we're already 6-0 up?
Yeah. Yeah, well, to be honest, I thought, what's going on?
I didn't get carried away. You know,
it's just 3 points. If you win 1-0 or 8-0, it doesn't make a difference. We didn't win anything yet.
I felt like I was on board and I was part of the team. I was listening to Serena too about, OK, it's time to focus on the next game.
It felt like game by game we were growing. We knew we'd qualified to get into the quarterfinals, but we wanted a really big performance.
England manager Serena Wiegmann will miss their final group game of the Women's Euros tonight. It's against Northern Ireland after testing positive for COVID.
Well, good to lose her for that period of time. Obviously, she wasn't around camp. We had to do a lot of Zoom calls.
Serena Wiegmann was in charge of UEFA protocols, and we are 5 days away from England's guaranteed quarterfinal and 11 days away from a potential semi-final, so the timing is tricky.
I think tonight it will be OK, because all the preparation is done. For me, the concern is the next couple of days on the training field and preparing for a quarterfinal. That's my only concern.
I thought we started the game quite slow, to be honest. There was just some magic moments.
Onto Hemp, onto that left foot, charge down. Oh, Kirby! A sublime strike to break the Northern Ireland resistance.
So
So even when the team maybe weren't firing on all cylinders...
Here's Mead, shifts it onto her left!
We had these players that could just produce these. Everybody talked about a back heel in that Sweden game, but her goal against Northern Ireland, for me, was one of the best goals I've seen.
Brilliant!
At the time when it happened, I was like, wow, that was incredible.
Knowles in frightening form. Another message sent out to the heavyweights participating in this European Championships. England, the team to beat.
Football can be very much complicated sometimes. We overcomplicate it, we bring all these tactics and all the talk and the buzz around it, but Serena has an amazing knack of just simplifying things.
What's your secret?
Well, I don't think I've met very many secrets.
I think the fact that people find her difficult to read is her greatest strength. That's what keeps you on your toes.
I didn't clean my glasses. Can you see it?
I think she changed so much. She really gave us a sense of belief. And, you know, she had that communication in a manager that we've never had before.
Oh, it's a lot better.
She can be calm. I think that's one of her big attributes, and she passes that on to us as a team and individuals. She's Dutch, so she's very direct, but in a way we need that.
She's slowly understanding the English sense of humour, which is good. It's only took her 12 months. She likes to join in with the dancing and stuff. But it's nice to have, a coach that's a manager that's very personable and you can relate to in that respect.
I felt like she really understood where I came from and, like, had... you know, empathy for me as a human being, not something I've experienced a lot in football over the years. I like her directness, her honesty, and I can't, really express. Yeah, she's changed my career, really. This whole year's just changed everything.
Serena's the boss, but we need to be able to connect with her, and I think she's found a good way to do that with the England national team.
A couple of hours to go until that England-Spain quarter-final. Spain are without their best player. And within the last minute or so, we've just found out that Serena Wegman, the England manager, has tested negative for COVID, and therefore she will be on the touchline later.
The night before we travelled to Brighton, we had a team meeting late at night, and Serena's message was, we are going on lockdown, we're going into a bubble because of COVID, and she just said, we have 10 days to change our lives. Do we want to do it or do we not?
Well, she's named the same starting 11 in all three group games, and again, she's done the same tonight. Are you surprised she's gone with the same starting 11?
No, I'm not surprised at all, and if you know anything about Serena Wiegman, what she done when she won it with the Netherlands was exactly the same. The great thing what she's got with this squad is eager players ready to come on and make a difference. If I even was on the bench here, I wouldn't be bothered about being on the bench because I know at some stage I'm going to get a chance and then it's up to me to try and take that chance.
How are we feeling? The knockout stages of Euro 2022 start right here. No room for error. One mistake, one hesitation, and your tournament is over. England's targeting a place in the final four of a major tournament.
Spain game was huge. That one.
I don't think it was tactically that we struggled against Spain, or technically, really. I think sometimes you just have to hold your hands up and say, Spain are a very good team. They are a very good team. They're going to possess the ball.
England really, really struggled in the first 45 minutes. We couldn't get Kira Walsh in the game. I think Bomati for Spain literally dominated that game, and I was in awe of her.
That seemed to be the game where they decided to really turn up the heat and the volume and make it really difficult for us.
England have been tested, no doubt about it, at half-time.
Some of our players, I think, look tired.
We've got to do something to take a chance on when they come up, that we can then exploit the space that they're leaving, because at the moment they're comfortable everywhere on the pitch.
Serena Wiegmann is here tonight out of her COVID isolation, because I imagine she's going to have a lot to do, a lot to sort out right now.
Esther Gonzalez strikes first.
The atmosphere just hit the floor in the stadium, and it hit the floor in the studio. And you're thinking, okay, this is not where we thought this tournament was going to go.
We conceded a goal for the first time in the tournament, so that was obviously a tough moment that we had.
Players that could come on and bring a lot of energy to this England team. Alessia's going to come on, Tooney's going to come on. Like, we knew what our plan was.
And yeah. You're going, is this going to happen for us? Is this really it?
Queuing up, nodded wide by Paredes. Oh, Lucy Bronze, corner heel, lovely feet. Sheila Garcia.
Clake, they think they've done it.
10 minutes to go. Are England heading out at the quarter-final stage?
10 minutes to go, England are behind. And at that point, as the person who's presenting the show, you start thinking about how you're going to finish the night. And this was not just finishing the night, this was going to be finishing England's Euros. And so I'd started to kind of scribble words for the end of the show, think about the chat, what we were going to talk about, and it was really a post-mortem chat.
Well, when you're down and they scored a goal in the second half, then you know when it's the 18th minute.
Brits. This has been done before.
There was a realisation on the pitch, you felt, that the players kind of got this message almost mentally that we're going out of this. If we don't do something, we're going out of this tournament.
Finds herself some space. Finds Hemp. It's towards Russo. There it is! In Wiegmann we trust. England back in it.
That was the most important goal of the tournament, I'd say. If that didn't go in, we could have been knocked out there and then, which is crazy to think.
Serena being able to react and know that she needed to change things tactically showed what a top coach and her insight and how she sees the game unfold and being able to change things straight away.
We go again for... We'll get to the last four, the Women's European Championships.
You had 7.6 million people tuning in on the edge of their seats, going through the drama and just hoping to see the Lionesses through to a semi-final.
Like, this is how I felt within the team. We were just not going to be beaten, or not that easily anyway.
Georgia Stanley. Now I can remember I'm running and I was standing behind on the...
Goes for goal!
As soon as she hit it.
That was the moment where I was thinking, we've just found a way to win this game, even when our back's up against the wall. It was just like nobody was ready to give up.
England could be in trouble here, but Bonmatí off balance wide.
I think the Spain game, for us, made us realise we could win this tournament.
Like, we were destined to go home. I thought we were destined to bring it home. It's weird. As soon as we equalised, I knew we were going to win the game. I just knew it.
Yes, there's 11 players on the pitch, but this is about 13, 14 players that could come on and make a massive difference. Having that in your back pocket, which Serena had, is priceless.
After that Spain game, I think everything changed. You had a lot of people talking about this team could actually get to Wembley. This team could actually lift that trophy. I think that's when the talk started turning serious.
It's not that easy to win a Euros. And the teams that were...
Still left in Germany, France, Sweden.
Yeah, Germany were looking good.
Germany were the one team that I was like, they are
England, and can they go on to make this final? I remember the word Wembley being mentioned in a lot, but we weren't there yet. We still had to get past a very good Sweden side.
always tough to play against Sweden, ranked number 2 in the world. It was never going to be an easy game.
Literally on the travels up there, I was in my head thinking, how's this game going to go? And 4 is my lucky number. It's the fourth time of trying to win this tournament. And so lots of 4s kept coming up.
Well, we've got you, Farah. I know you love being put on the spot. What's your score prediction?
4-0, guys. I'm going 4-0. Playing big. We'll have a bit of that. Gabby.
I thought Farah had gone mad when she predicted 4-0 against Sweden, because Sweden are a really good team with top-class players. There was something in the air. She was just, like, maybe she was soaking it in a bit too much.
Here we are, one game away from Wembley. Semi-final stage at Euro 2022. England have fallen at this stage in each of the last 3 major tournaments. Sweden denied the Lionesses the bronze medal at the last World Cup. Both Sweden and England had to fight to get to their place in the semi-finals. Expecting an extremely competitive game today between 2 of the forces of women.
Back-to-back semi-finals that you failed to make it through to a final from. You go back to 2015 World Cup, then you go 2017 European Championships, then you go to another World Cup, you make a semi-final. It must be very difficult to not think you're destined to stay at that semi-final stage.
Jakobsen is through here. Jakobsen scoffs the effort.
How do you change that? How do you go that one step beyond? What is it that is holding us back?
Oh, off the bar! Sweden getting closer and closer.
We knew that they would come out, and they, you know, they were physical, competitive. Yeah, it was a tough exchange, you know, it's a semi-final.
This is Beth Mead's tournament. We're just here to watch.
What I like about that kind of finish and what you want from players when they're in that region of the goal is just to get the technique right. The touch was right and the strike was just perfect. You know, and it's the kind of goal that you need to you score at that stage, settles everybody down, and it just shows again that the player of the tournament, given half a chance, is going to punish you.
Ida here, bronze with a free header, and it's in!
I've known for a long time that Beth was a top player. I think the only person that needed to believe that was Beth.
Less than a year ago, I wasn't selected for the Olympics. Obviously, I was in not a great place after non-selection. It lit a fire inside of me. And not let that one moment define me.
We did, like, an exercise where we put in pairs, and me and Beth were actually put together, and you had to write a note to each other. And me and Beth have a good relationship, but it's not serious. Can't remember word for word what I said, but it was something along the lines of, you haven't surprised me at this tournament because I have always known that you were that good, kind of thing. She actually told me the other day that I think she just moved house or something, and she still has it. But it was funny because I wrote a joke at the end, because she was like, we couldn't even write a serious note to each other, there was still a joke.
Lovely build-up. Oh! Wow! What was that?
Oh! The cheek!
I said, where have you pulled that out from? I've never seen Les do that in a life, and I've known Les a long, long time. I honestly couldn't believe that she did that.
She, did a crazy, and yeah, nutmegs 2 players are back in a semi-final to do that. Yeah, wild.
What an unbelievable iconic goal that was.
I'll say they don't look the most excited to get on the field. Lena Hurtig and Hannah Bennison coming on. Stina Blackstenius being withdrawn.
Lindell can't keep it out!
one of those moments where you're like, everything's playing out. Like, this is it. A game at Wembley, a home Euros. When you see the goals that were scored in the semi-final, Russo scoring the cheeky back heel that she did. You know, just everything seemed to be clicking into place.
People are like, why are you crying? I'm like, crying my eyes out because I wanted it so much. I couldn't imagine not being in a final with this team. For me, this was the first final that I'd ever reached with England.
What I would say with it is that when you look at what it is, whatever happens in the final now, if girls are not allowed to play football just like the boys can in their PE after this tournament, then what are we doing? Yeah. We've got to make sure that they are able to play and get the opportunity to do this, because this is going to inspire a lot of people. But if there's no legacy to this, like what we saw with the Olympics, if there's no legacy after this, then what are we doing? Because girls should be able to play, because this is as proud as I've ever felt of any England stuff.
Walking away from Bramall Lane after the Sweden game, I remember thinking, I walked away from this ground many times before. It's never felt like this.
England v Germany at Wembley. It was meant to happen, wasn't it?
Good morning, gorgeous. Welcome to the final day of July.
Is it coming home, Richie?
Well, I don't want to get too carried away and say it's coming home, but it's certainly sat in the departure lounge.
History may be made. It may be coming home.
Kick off at 5 on BBC One. Alex Scott and the rest of the team will be bringing us the final of the Euros.
To be honest, we weren't that aware of how much or how crazy the country was getting. Obviously, when you speak to our families, they were like, you know, it's kind of a bit mental, you know, in the outside world.
During the tournaments, I'm actually really as much as possible in my own bubble. And of course, I noticed, you know, all the people coming to the stadium. And sometimes what you see on TV, we didn't put on the TV that much.
Personally, I didn't really look. I tried to block everything out.
What did you do on the morning of the final?
What I do all the time before a game, I just wake up, do some little exercise, then go and have breakfast. I had an omelette, very good omelette of Gerrit, our chef. Didn't do anything differently than I normally do before a game.
On the morning of the final, I had this kind of feeling like, wow, today could be enormous. This could be huge. If they beat Germany at Wembley, at a full Wembley, this is a seminal moment in the sport.
Yes, we know it was a very big game. It's a final year at Wembley. But it wasn't that. We were calm, we were excited, and we had a plan, we had a strategy. We just knew we were really ready to go.
In the build-up to the final, we were focusing on Alex Pop. Her and Beth Mead both scored 6 goals, so, you know, you had this great head-to-head. You don't get that in finals very often.
I was a bit nervous, actually, because for me, I think I'd seen a German team getting back their identity of old, you know, playing down the flanks, getting crosses in, being dominant. A player like Alexandra Pop.
Her movement in the box is so effective and so dangerous and so hard to mark. She takes, you know, defenders into areas that they don't want to go, and she's the powerhouse that attacks the box.
I couldn't make this up!
OK, we got past Spain, but this is a complete...
Just had helicopters just following us the whole way.
Me and Hempo were too intrigued at what the helicopter was doing the whole journey. We was just looking out the window the whole time.
Everyone in their cars was almost like stopping, you know, hanging out their windows.
Arriving at Wembley, the crowds were crazy.
87,000 people were coming to watch us at Wembley and supporting us. Cameras everywhere, and the crowd just looked insane. It looked electric.
And it was, wow, now it's the final.
was hobbling off the pitch and going down the tunnel, and a rumour quickly coming to our ear that, you know, pops out of the game. And I'm like, you mean we're going to win the Euros?
That was huge, to have their number one player, who was going to be our biggest test, and for her not to be playing. That's when I turned back to Gabby and I said to her, this is it. This is it.
The finale of a record-breaking tournament ends here. England versus Germany at Wembley Stadium. It's almost as if they had this date with each other from the beginning. A tournament that has smashed attendance records for European Championships will break another today. The biggest crowd in a Euros final, male or female, one that has stood since 1964.
Nobody in that team, bar one, I think, had ever played in a European Championship final. That's when you talk about levels of experience, or, you know, Germany was a young team.
Early charge.
AG, to start with.
Mia Williamson clearing up again. Made more recoveries than anyone else without making a single tackle during this tournament, Leah Williamson. It's been described as a final, I think, two of the best coaches as well, haven't we?
I was sat there and I was so nervous. I was sitting there as an England fan, really. All them years of hurt, the men's team, the women's team. And I just wanted us to win so badly.
This has been a little Earps grabs. Somehow England survived.
To be honest with you, I never thought I would get back to this point. I didn't think I was even going to be in a squad for a major tournament again, let alone playing in a final against Germany at Wembley. I can sort of vividly remember the days of, yeah, feeling really down, and I'd sort of reached my limits and given it a good go, but I just wasn't quite good enough. I had responsibility. I'll give it a couple more years. And then Serena come in the September and, yeah, life changed. Literally like that.
Back for White! What a chance!
They're one of the best teams of the world. And we are a very good team too. So at halftime, we actually said, this is a very tight game. And we just have to keep playing our best game to be able to win this.
My two German players, including Magul, is Rauch. First time ball in, it's left. Magul! What a chance. Big, big chance.
And if England needed a warning sign, then that is it.
At some point. And it became a thing, didn't it?
Of course, you always want to play for England, and I think everyone wants to start. That's why we are where we are, and we're such competitive people. But Serena did it so well where you knew your role in the tournament, and I knew my role was... We know how good Kira is as a player, and the tournament she had, she was unbelievable, and I knew that if I would make that run...
Oh, and the tune is through here! And the tune for England! What a goal! We have lift off!
I didn't think that I was at Wembley playing against Germany in a final in front of all those people. I just thought it's another game of football.
Enjoy the moment, recompose, go again.
Being at the back and a lot of the time being so far away from it, I like to just take that
off the post and Earps gathers.
England need to get control of this game again.
A football game, it's 90 minutes long. One goal doesn't determine the result, and I've been on the bad side of that.
Can she work the opening?
When they equalise, that's the first time throughout the tournament where it just took a lot out of me to be so close. Like, this cannot be the way that it ends.
That's a little push. We need to find the energy from somewhere. Kelly buys the corner and chews up the crowd.
this is what Serena Wiegmann will have planned for, to carve out that one opportunity.
Felt so quiet to me. I didn't hear the roar of the crowd. In that moment, I couldn't hear anything other than the girls on the pitch.
England lead in extra time. Just produced the fairy tale result for England.
I was excited. I was obviously so nervous, sat on the bench waiting for the final whistle to go.
Still time left for Germany to find another reply. Cheers as loud for that as almost as much as for Chloe Kelly's goal.
The last 10 minutes waiting for that final whistle. I don't know, I think I kept looking around the stadium.
Minutes away.
Second half of extra time, and I am so tired. And I'm emotionally I'm just drained at this point.
Leah, I think she was
but the girls had the ball in the corner for so long, otherwise I think I'd have been useless.
Less than 30 seconds to go. Final throw of the dice for Germany. Froome sends it forward. Jill Scott is there first. England! European champions! For the very first time!
I was a little bit in shock.
I still get goosebumps now thinking about it. We were crying, we were laughing, we were celebrating with the fans, all in like 1 minute of what felt like madness. Honestly, like I get a lump in my throat thinking about it, like how special that moment was, and you can't explain how much it meant to us. And yeah, I think I'll replay that moment forever.
All I kept thinking in my head was nothing will ever change what we've just done. No matter what anybody says or does, or what we've just done will be written forever.
The greatest memory has got to be Leah walking with the trophy. We're all there on the podium and lifting a trophy with England, which doesn't happen very often. Yeah, it's a really special moment, really.
Going through the game, it was magnificent. The jeopardy at the end and the last minute goal, it was like a film. It was like if you wrote a script for a film.
It was a tremendous performance we had. We won the European Championships. So sure, did you have a little party?
Got on the table, looked up and just seen a load of cameras and I thought, yeah, what have I done here? But I had to commit to it and that was it. So then I just jiggled my hips a bit and then off I went.
It really landed a little more after the tournament. But it went crazy. It's really, really inspiring, actually.
Yeah, life's been a little bit different. Let's say we get recognised a little bit more than we used to.
When I got home, I said to my husband, wait up, and we had a gin and tonic, sat outside. It was a hot, hot evening, warm evening. And we have a view of London and you can see Wembley Arch and it was still lit up. And I sat there and I remember saying, I've never felt so happy. I think it was all those years of expectation, disappointment, trying to encourage and get people involved and get people to see that this was a sport worth kind of being a part of and wanting people to get behind them and hoping that, you know, attitudes would change. And it felt it taken such a long time to get there. And yeah, it was poignant, I think.
The
class of 22. I don't think any summer will ever beat it.
I think we've inspired the next generation of young girls to want to try and get involved in football and to feel like they can.
We respect we've even got to today. Blood, sweat and tears went into it beforehand, and I think we just have a collective appreciation for what happened before we did what we did.
Times I felt like we as players, not female players, not male players, were home.
We made history. We changed the course of women's football forever in England, and each one of us played our part in that. And yeah, created a special memory, a special bond that will surely last a lifetime.